It is a busy day in the world of space travel, especially right here in Central Florida's Space Coast.
There have already been two launches today, one from Cape Canaveral, as we know, another in Texas with a Central Florida tie, and there's a third set for tonight at the Cape. We are checking in on those launch conditions, but first, we're also looking ahead to the next crewed mission from the Kennedy Space Center.
That's right. They gave two briefings. One included these astronauts behind us. West 2's Scott Hyler joins us live. And Scott, what's in store for Crew 5?
Well, this mission is currently targeting a launch on September 29th, launch pad 39A here. And it's the first time that a Russian cosmonaut will be aboard a NASA SpaceX flight. And Crew 5 will have the first female commander on a NASA SpaceX mission.
And I think it's important that young girls realize that they have these leadership opportunities for them. But from an operational perspective, to be honest, it really doesn't matter if you're, you know, a woman or a man or what country you're from.
The two NASA test pilots are joined by the cosmonaut and a veteran astronaut from the Japanese Space Agency. In the mission leadership briefing, partner cooperation was repeatedly touched on. This in light of Russia's announcement last week that it was pulling out of the space station in 2024. Clarification from the Russian Space Agency.
Perhaps something was lost in the translation, but the statement actually said that Russia will not pull out of the program until after 2024.
He said nothing will change until at least 2025, and maybe not until the end of the ISS mission in 2030. And a new rideshare agreement between Roscosmos and NASA was announced recently. The Crew 5 mission will use the Endurance Dragon Crew spacecraft, the same as the Crew 3 mission, and a new Falcon 9 booster that was slightly damaged in transit, the reason the launch was pushed back until the end of September. With the Russian mission to the ISS earlier in September, the Crew 5 date might need to shift even more.
I suspect we'll adjust that date a little bit as we get in a little closer due to the proximity to the Soyuz operations.
And one message was clear in both of those briefings, both the crew and the leadership, and that is coordination, cooperation between these partners. A clear move to separate earthly tensions from what happens in low Earth orbit. Reporting live at the Kennedy Space Center, Scott Hyler, West 2 News.